Hello everyone, I'm Ashish and I'd like to welcome you all for Columbia Asia Health Awareness Session. Today we'll be speaking about gall bladder stone. We have Dr.Mriganka and Dr.Amit Deepta who will be talking about this topic. So let's start with the thing. Sir, please let us start with the basic. What is the cause of gall bladder stone and is it related to food habits?
Okay, I'll take that question. You know, very frankly speaking, even we are not sure as to why gallstones occur. There are several postulations and hypotheses, but no one knows exactly. According to one hypothesis, you know, it's because of infection in the bile, you know, of the bile that leads to gallbladder stones. According to another theory or another hypothesis, it's because of what we call supersaturation of cholesterol. You know, you have cholesterol and water which are held together in bile, and due to a change in the concentration of any one of them, then those stones may be formed. Or it may be because of a combination of both these factors.
Okay.
Frankly speaking, as I said, we really don't know what causes these stones, but these are some of the postulations that have been put forward. The food habits are not directly, you know, responsible for causing gallbladder stones.
Mm-hmm.
If it has to happen, it will happen irrespective of what we eat.
Okay.
Right.
So, sir, how does one come to know if he or she has the gallbladder stone?
See, to know whether he or she is having gallbladder stones, it can be evident from the symptoms or presentations.
Okay.
Right? So one of the most common presentation is that he or she will feel fullness after taking meal, any major meals. Associated with that, he or she can have right upper abdominal pain that will radiate to the back or upper shoulder.
Okay.
These two are the most common symptoms. I think if anybody has this kind of symptoms, he or she should immediately consult one physician.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, the most common investigations we advise or they should do is ultrasonography abdomen. It is the least invasive and easily available modality of diagnosis.
Mm-hmm.
So after getting an good ultrasound of the abdomen, mm-hmm. he or she can be sure that whether he or she has gallstone or not.
Mm-hmm. Sir, is there any non-surgical way also to treat the gallbladder stone?
See, first and foremost, we have to decide which are the patients that need treatment. A lot of patients come to us where, you know, gallbladder stones have been picked up incidentally in some sort of routine checkup or routine medical checkup. Not all of these patients need treatment. There are a certain subset of patients where even incidental gallbladder stones need to be picked. Dealt with, like, you know, diabetic patients who had typhoid, right? But for those who've had symptoms or the other set of patients where radiological test like an ultrasound shows inflammation, definitely some sort of treatment is required.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, there is no non-surgical treatment for gallbladder stones. The only modality of treatment which is definitive for gallbladder stones is removal of the gallbladder. Nowadays, the surgery is done laparoscopically, that is by keyhole method. But of course, whenever we do a surgery laparoscopically, there is a very minute chance that it may get converted into an open surgery. But the majority of cases can be done laparoscopically and very safely.
As sir rightly mentioned, as far as surgeries are concerned, the complete gauntlet is. So when it comes to kidney stone, it is only the stones which are removed. So why is it so?
The answer of this question lies in the pathogenesis of the gallbladder stones. Right?
Mm-hmm.
In the pathogenesis of gallbladder stones is completely different from the pathogenesis of kidney stones. When gallbladder stone forms when the inner wall of the gallbladder is diseased. That means the organ is already diseased.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Because that the organ is diseased, that's why stones have been formed.
Okay.
Right? So whereas in kidney stones, there is some metabolic error like high calcium levels, high oxalate level like that, whether the function of the organ is absolutely fine.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So in kidney stones, you don't remove the kidney.
Okay.
And in gallbladder stones, as the organ is diseased itself, so this is the only way out. We just remove the diseased organ.
Sir, if we remove the gallbladder stone, so has it has some kind of adverse effect on the health of the patient?
No, actually this is one of the most frequently asked questions by the patients. You know, we need to understand that the gallbladder per se does not have any digestive property. It is just a storehouse of extra bile, right? So when the gallbladder is removed, it does not have any major adverse effect on the digestion of the patient.
Okay.
As I said, because the bile itself is not produced in the gallbladder.
Mm-hmm.
Bile or pit, as we call it in Hindi, is produced in the liver. And it is taken down by the bile ducts into the duodenum or the upper part of the intestine.
Okay.
The excess part of the bile gets stored in the gallbladder.
Okay.
Right? So it has no direct function which affects the digestion of the patient. So removal does not have any untoward effect on the digestion of the patient.
Okay. So let's say, sir, if the person don't want to go for the surgery, what can happen?
See, there are certain complications of gallbladder stones, right? If you divide the complications, let me say local complications or distant complications, right? So far as local complication is concerned, if a person is having multiple stones, multiple small stones, this stone can dislodge and newly lodged in the CVD. CVD is the common bile duct that opens in the intestine. It is the drain pathway of the bile, right? So if stone lodges in CVD, then it creates problem.
Mm-hmm.
The bile flow is obstructed, patient can have jaundice, and it has its specific complications, right?
Mm-hmm.
Even the at the point of end of the CVD, the duct of the pancreas also opens. So sometimes stone can go move towards the pancreatic duct and damage the pancreas. Moreover, as we all know, the intestines lie quite nearer to the gallbladder and CVD.
Mm-hmm.
So the gallbladder stone can cause obstructions of the intestine also. The most dreaded complication, especially in the northern belt of the India, is starting from Jammu and Kashmir to northeastern states,
mm-hmm.
is that the gallbladder stone is one of the most common cause of gallbladder cancer.
Okay.
Right? So if we don't operate, we can keep them.
Okay.
Literature has shown that some percentage of patients can convert their disease to gallbladder malignancy. It is one of the most dreaded complications.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it can lead to cancer.
Yeah, it can lead to cancer.
Okay. That was a quite in detailed information that we got. I'd like to thank our specialists. And also, if you have further any questions, please comment on the in the box, and we'll be happy to answer you back. Thank you.
Thank you so much.